It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down the word. How wonderful.
This is Josh Schwartz. Can I ask you to play the first time?
The moss, well, a few of the verses, well, they've got me quite a lot.
All we have to do is sit quietly and wait for the sound of the pipes, which will signify that the heat is on the
been a wee bit of a technical hitch. I think that's the best way to describe it. Earl and Kate can't get married today because they don't have permission from the Home Office to get married. Earl, in case you didn't know it, is an American, and the Home Office like about 5 years for you to apply. I'm joking about the 5 years, but it seems like that, to apply for permission to get married in Scotland. And sadly, that permission hasn't come through yet. So what we're going to do today is we're going to have a service of blessing and of commitment and a wedding in all but legal terms. So Kate and Earl are going to say vows to each other, we're going to sing hymns, we're going to have friends reading and people singing, and we're going to celebrate their love and their marriage today, but at another date, still to be decided, because the permission hasn't come through yet. We're going to have a wee quiet time, and they can sign the legal document and they can go as a married couple. If you would like to protest against that, then the current Home Secretary is Theresa May, and if you write a letter to her at the Home Office expressing your disappointment, then please do that. But today is a service of celebration and of blessing and of commitment and of joy. And it's very important that we're all here today to join in the happiness of Earl and Kate. Let me tell you how romantic Earl is. He's just said to Kate as she came up the aisle, "I love you." And I thought, oh, just let's just do this. Let's just get on with it. Can I say a couple of things to you before we begin? First of all, can you try not to take flash photography during the service? Because Earl and Kate are going to say some important words to each other, and I wouldn't like anything to interrupt that. And can you also make sure that you turn your mobile phones off? Sorry to sound like a head teacher. I really am a minister, I'm not a head teacher. But those are all my bits and pieces. And later on, we'll be lighting the Unity candle. Shelley and Lorna have already done that, but Kate and I will do that together. And as I say, we've got contributions from people who are friends and family and neighbours. And this is a joyful day and one to be celebrated. Let us worship God. I invite you to stand as we sing together the first hymn on your order of service, "Will You Come and Follow Me?"
When do we hold hands?
No.
Okay. You're the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
That's not the right song. That's not the right song.
Can I stop you there? Can I stop you there? Can somebody tap Anne on the shoulder?
It's not the right music. Will you come and follow me?
Will you come and follow me?
Okay.
I think we just have a round of applause. Here we go.
Go.
I don't know. That's what I said.
It's in the hymn book, Anne.
It's okay.
While Anne's finding that, let me just fill you in a bit of detail. Oh no, we're off. We're fine. And praise for all your gifts of goodness and grace. We praise you for your gift of love uniting our families, blessing our lives, enfolding us all our days. Especially we thank you for the love which dwells and grows in the hearts of Earl and Kate, and for the happiness and trust that has led them here. As they seek now to confirm that happiness and deepen that trust, may your spirit of love sanctify their joy and enrich their love. Guide them by your grace, surround them with your presence, and keep them in your love through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Will the congregation please be standing? Kate and Earl, would you like to hold hands? And Earl, will you look at Kate and repeat after me? Kate, I offer you peace.
Kate, I offer you peace.
I offer you love.
I offer you love.
I offer you friendship.
I offer you friendship.
I see your beauty.
I see your beauty.
I hear your need.
I hear your need.
I feel your feelings.
I feel your feelings.
Let us work together unity and love.
Let us work together for unity and love.
And Kate, will you look at Earl and repeat after me? Earl, I offer you peace.
Earl, I offer you peace.
I offer you love.
I offer you love.
I offer you friendship.
I offer you friendship.
I see your beauty.
I see your beauty.
I hear your need.
I hear your need.
I feel your feelings.
I feel your feelings.
Let us work together for unity and love.
Let us work together for unity and love.
And as a sign of the vows that you've made to one another, we're going to exchange rings. Earl, would you like to take Kate's ring, which I think might be the smaller of the two?
Yes, yes.
And just place it on her finger.
Nice nails.
Kate, would you take Earl's ring and place it on his finger? So sweet.
It's almost on. Keep going.
Maybe by the time we get married. Wrong side.
Oh, is that the wrong size?
Earl's obviously spent too much time in Scotland and has been eating too many pies and chips.
It's not good. It'll go on, Jess.
It'll work, but just looking to bend your finger a little bit.
It's
and I promise you, by the end of the service, it will be over. Carry on, holding hands just now, and let us pray. Loving Lord, we give thanks for the commitment shown to each other by Kate and Earl. For the love that they've promised each other, for the joy that unfolds them. We pray that you will bless their relationship, their commitment, their friendship, their future, that they might walk in your paths and in your presence all the days of their lives. In Jesus' name we ask this. Amen. Earl, I think as a sign of the fact that you can't quite get your ring on, but we're nearly there, you want to give Kate a big kiss. And you can give him a wee bit of encouragement.
Chosen by God for this new life of love, dress in the wardrobe God picked out for you. Compassion, kindness, humility, quiet strength, discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place, quick to forgive an offense. Forgive as quickly and completely as the Master forgave you. And regardless of what else you put on, wear love. It's your basic all-purpose garment. Never be without it. Let the peace of Christ keep you in tune with each other, in step with each other. None of this is going off and doing your own thing. And cultivate thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, the message, have the run of the house. Give it plenty of room in your lives. Instruct and direct one another using good common sense. And sing your hearts out to God. Let every detail in your lives, words, actions, whatever, be done in the name of the Master Jesus, thanking God, the Father, every step of the way.
Okay. I'm reading
Ecclesiastes.